We've just changed our brand from Ramada to Radisson Blu. We're very pleased with that because we'll get a lot more international business being referred to us. But we welcome the new competition coming in. It's going to be challenging for us and for the new boys arriving in town. But we welcome that. It's always great to have something new to aim for, and we're looking forward to it. We discovered 10, 15 years ago, just after we were here, that you know there's a tremendous fun element within Doha, but also they have to get what the public require, and that is that they need to have a selection. For example, here in the hotel, we have up to 22 food and beverage outlets. And the food and beverage offering that we have, the selection is there. Other hotels maybe not do that. They come in with one coffee shop and one specialty restaurant. But really, they should think again in some of their plans. And we have been here, and people have been extremely, not envious or jealous or anything, but they regard us as one of the major leading lights, if you like, for the food and beverage offerings in Doha. There is a call for another couple of good four-star hotels and maybe one or two three-star hotels. But, you know, you come to the Middle East, and the Middle East is a place now, probably the last remaining place on Earth, where you can get such luxurious service. And that's what we like to promote, and that's what we like to practice. We have got an absolutely tremendous work ethic, not just in the Radisson Blu here, but certainly throughout the Middle East. We can offer these luxury services, and that's what we want to retain. So five-star will always have a big place. I hope we don't go down that there'll be a rate war, which may happen, but you know, we've got to sustain our average rates to make the thing payable. We've gone down, I must say this, last year. We've gone down a little bit since the 2008-2009 recession. I would say about 7 to 8%. But the numbers of visitors have gone up, proportionally about 3 to 4%. So we're just about there. No matter if there's more hotels coming on board, they will take their 5% from the existing market right across all the hotels, 3%, 5%. They will come up to their 60% occupancy. And then we will also go down a wee little bit, but there's more business coming in. And by any facts, the level of business coming into Doha especially will be increasing. I would say certainly there's more tourism is required. But I think that there's more infrastructure required before the tourists are advertised, etc. And Qatar Airways is a wonderful airline, and we're going to over 100 destinations now, so you know there is certainly growth there, and growth for the future 10, 20 years. I don't think it should be only high-end. I think it should be right across the board, quite frankly. A tourist is a tourist. We've got this World Cup coming. It's the Ford Cortina man that comes to the World Cup, not the Rolls-Royce man that comes to the World Cup, so I would suggest that we just keep the way we're going right at the present moment, right across the board and right across the world, and get all types of tourists coming here. I would suggest for that we should really think about a sort of Disneyland fair, fun fair attraction in a major way. We have a new water park, Aqua Park, which is just outside town, but we talked about this maybe 15, 20 years ago to have a fun fair attraction, which we had a small one. But really, to get the place going, to get tourists coming here, we should have a major Disney, like a Disney park. I would suggest that we could also go down the route of some extra golf clubs. That would also be appreciated. Some were planned, but they've been put on the sort of the back burner for the moment until we find out exactly what. I think the World Cup is taking focus now, and correctly so. We've got about 10 years to get this thing absolutely right, with all the stadiums, the infrastructure for the railways, the new roads, bypasses, flyovers, tunnels, motor systems and motor boats and all that sort of thing, plus the new international airport has arrived, new Doha International Airport. And that's going to be a tremendous benefit to us. I've worked in the majority of other Middle Eastern countries, from Jordan, Egypt, the Gulf, etc., etc. And I think that Qatar is one of the most wonderful places. We've been here 22 years. One of the most wonderful places for not so much culture, but for friendliness, for cooperation, for enjoyment. We've got tremendous fun here, and it really is sun, sand, sea, all that sort of thing. But there's another major one, and that is security. And Qatar certainly is a very secure country within the Middle East. Very satisfactory.